Hey guys, it is Tristan with Nerdette's Newsstand, and with the oversaturation of Harley Quinn in all forms of media, whether it is current comic books, Black Label comic books, games, or even her live action version played by Margot Robbie, it is hard to get a fan excited to read current comics and Harley Quinn. Now, I have always said that Harley was the best as Joker's punching bag. It is something I have stood by and I still do. But that version of Harley Quinn, as we know it, has been completely erased. Whether it is, you know, before New 52 and she started to get away, or in New 52 when she completely got away, changed her look, and everything kind of was changed. Now, again, there are different versions, a lot of different versions of this. But the gold standard when it comes to Harley Quinn is, of course, the animated series that was done so flawlessly that people loved it, and it was brought into the comics. And we've seen Mad Love, we've seen the introduction of this wonderful character, and she absolutely exploded, whether it was in the comics or on the screen. She was one that took off very quickly. Now, there is a lot of versions of Harley Quinn. We've talked about Elseworlds stories before, a lot, because they are some of my favorite stories, but specifically, I want to talk about two comics that came out, one this week and one last week. And I've been reading basically anything related to the character, and I usually do. But here's the thing. Harley, as we know it, as she was, is gone. Now we have a new version of Harley that is fantastic, actually. Both of these, for very different reasons, are wonderful. I love that we have an amazing relationship with Ivy in one, and we're going to go through that. I love that we see her as a very strong mother in another, and both combined, it makes sense. If Harley is not going to be a punching bag, an abused victim of Stockholm Syndrome, we should see her be a stronger woman. And that's exactly what she needed. Now, I'm not talking in the way of, I am woman, hear me roar, give me every Mary Sue type power. I am talking in the way of an actual revival of being abused and then moving on, moving forward, and becoming her own woman. Well, that is what we see. So first I want to talk about Injustice. This is 2 weeks old, and during the original Injustice series, we got a little bit of a throwback. I believe it was in Injustice 270, when we seen Killer Croc and Orca get married. We had a little bit of a hint that Ivy and Harley were already married. Well, we do see Harley, break Ivy out here, and they are able to escape. Now, she goes through how she's being abused still. She goes through what Joker has done with her, and she actually introduces her to Lucy. Now, Lucy in Injustice is unfortunately kind of left behind, whereas I'm going to talk about another story where her children are not, but I like Harley as a mother, and there's a lot of reasons for that. She's a little crazy, of course, but she's also human. That's what makes her human. She's not perfect. She doesn't do everything right. She is not. In the next one, she'll say, you know, I'm a terrible mother. We see her as human. Whereas if we made a mother in the story by the way of Wonder Woman or somebody with powers, it would be very off. And we have before. We have seen, Wonder Woman have a child before when it comes to the Gog after Kingdom Come, but this makes more sense. So, of course, we see Ivy get upset at the bruises and, kind of defend her love. And they're not even really hinting how much they are in love, but they do go to Vegas. And we see something absolutely adorable. I love this story. It is by Tom Taylor, I forgot to mention, but we see these two basically say, we're going to continue this cycle. I'm going to continually get beat up by Joker. You're going to continually fight for the green and nothing's gonna change. Well, that's when Ivy asks Harley to marry her. And of course, we see a yes, and they actually do get married by an Elvis impersonator. I absolutely love these kinds of story. They make you feel good. They make you love the characters. They make you enjoy them as characters. Now, let's talk about one that actually came out this week. Again, another Elseworlds story. None of this is within continuity. In continuity, she's kind of just hanging out at the hospital, trying to avoid her insurance bills. So, we see the Harley Quinn when it comes to the Murphyverse, Batman White Knight. Now, in the original story, there was two Harley Quinns, right? And it kind of separated the original Harley Quinn to the newer version. And I really liked how they made that, right? We had new Joker, right? And it was Harley. So I love it. But obviously, spoilers, this version is very different. She was actually a stripper, right? She was actually, that's how she met Jack Napier. And that's how they kind of fell in love. Well, she was the one that basically corrupted him. And I do like the puns, the silliness, the fun. What I love even more is to see this human, compassionate side of Harley Quinn as she reads to her kids as a goodnight story, telling them about Joker, about their father, not hiding it from them. And then absolutely, if you've ever stepped on a Lego before, you'll know exactly why she's mad. But stepping on a toy, right? And then absolutely just killing it because she can. This story is not by Sean Gordon Murphy. It's actually by his wife. And it's not even his art. It looks like it. It completely blends in with the Murphyverse. But this story is so perfectly done. I don't think I could do it better myself. We even see her go visit Bruce. And we see the honest side of Harley. A side that we don't normally see. The human side, right? So she says, you know, she brought her babies. Of course, she brought her hyenas. And she says, oh my God, I forgot about, you know, my kids. I said my babies and I meant, you know, my hyenas. And we see her break down. We see her break down to a person that she actually considers a good friend and quite possibly even more, right? And she says, you know, I'm a horrible mother. I why didn't I think of these things? Why didn't I think of them? And we see a real human interaction between both Bruce and Harley. And I have seen there be some pushback to this. Like, oh my God, Harley's a single mother. That's horrible. What? No, duh. If you read the first leading up to this, if you read White Knight and then Curse of the White Knight, you all of this would make sense. And you wouldn't be saying, you know, why is she a single mother? She's a single mother because she's gone through a lot. She's a single mother because she overcame Jack Napier. They got, you know, had a baby. He died. And here is where we're at. And Bruce is now one of her best friends. Obviously, he turns himself in and he is in jail. I'm not going to go through everything, but all of this makes sense. And it's actually so flawlessly done that I don't see the issue because these people exist. Mothers exist. Single mothers exist. Women exist. All of this is okay. And it's good. It's not just okay. It's really, really good. Sean Gordon Murphy does a good job of having that friend that gives you the pep talk, right? And that's Bruce here. No, you're not a terrible mother. You're this. Men, that's okay, right? Like, all of these things are pretty fucking normal. I absolutely enjoyed this story. And now we are getting to see Harley back, you know, she doesn't have her medical license back, but I'm assuming she will, but back as her version of Harley Quinzel, right? And I loved everything about these two stories. Like I said, there is an oversaturation of Harley Quinn stories. There really is. And I would say, for, you know, reading suggestions would be Steven Stajek, Harleen, and then obviously Bruce Timm and Paul Dini's Mad Love. But these are second to those stories if you like the Elseworld version of Harley. A Harley without Joker. A Harley that is actually independent and well-educated and completely humanized. And I think that's the best part about it. So let me know, of course, what you guys think about this, whether you enjoy, you know, the Murphyverse or do not. Same with Injustice Year Zero, if you're enjoying Tom Taylor's run or not. I'm enjoying them both. I think they're fantastic. So let me know, of course, what you guys think about this, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye. Hey guys, I want to give a huge shout out to my Patreon and Subscribe Stars. You guys literally make this channel possible. Huge thank you to Cage the Mick, Robert Mick Twiz, Black Knight Fool, Brucey, Chris Z, David L, David Rofford, Jeffrey Allen Carnes, Mighty Balls, Mike Buckner, Mizen Barbosa, Ruskar, Ryan Decker, Robert Hoffman, and Doc Holliday. You guys are absolutely amazing, and thank you so much for all your support. Don't forget on the way out to like as always if you enjoy the content and hit subscribe. And I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.